every year we are training students in Yantra. Around 30 to 40 students in a semester, they have been trained in through embedded systems, Yantra laboratory. And Yantra lab helped us a lot to give a knowledge, to share a knowledge to the students, not only our electrical engineering students, and also the other branch students like civil engineering, mechanical engineering. They do some interdisciplinary work based on this knowledge, and they do some simple projects, and they use some sensors to measure the vibration in the building. Like that, they build small projects based on the embedded system knowledge that they got it from Yantra laboratory.
We faced a problem of power constraint. So since all these motherboards are like power hungry, we need to give more power to it. Since we settle on a battery which is like less weight, we can't feed the motherboard the right amount of current it requires for all the CUDA cores to activate. So we saw a little accuracy drops while in the real time. Instead of doing everything individually and then implementing it, I would request them to do the implementations or the integrations on the first itself. So like if you are working on 2 to 3 nodes, just put the two to three nodes together and then run and see. If you don't get any errors or accuracy issues there, you won't be getting it on the final implementations. So never ever work around near high main lines. Like so that's a main thing where our Jetson was like into an accident. We were working with not a very good adapter. We were having an SMPS. So I request everyone to use the proper adapters and proper power feeders, the back motors of the board. They were giving different encoder values. Not like they were not in sync. So if we think that the right motor has given like 20, the value of 20, the left motor gives a value of 19 or 18 or so. So what this causes is, even if the robot is in a straight line, in the visualization tool, what we get, the robot is tilted a little bit since the values are not correct. So everything from the chassis model to the each and every wheel, the loading of each and every wheel, the speed differs. Since we have a back wheel drive, we didn't know that we should keep all the heavyweight backwards. Their suggestions for us in the project was very useful, and their reviews were so useful for us. So we don't think any competition would have a review session like this. And they'd be stating out all their suggestions. They do suggested us what the problems were and how to solve them. So I don't think there is any other competition which gives you mentors like we can interact with them to get a more technical aspect, technical knowledge from them.